7116 Flagstaff. It's on the corner of East Spring and Flagstaff. And East Spring's a lot less busy. Flagstaff really isn't that busy. It does have the double yellow line. It's a little bit more of a main road, but it's not too bad. Decent area, surrounding houses look fine. No visible damage on the roof. It goes downhill that way. I really can't get a view on the back of the roof. There's no visible damage on the inside. It's a pretty small yard, small front and backyard. Hard driveways on East Spring, it's not on Flagstaff. So we pull in on side road. Driveway has quite a few cracks and pretty unlevel in some spots. Like I said, it's a really small yard, the back of the house. You can see some of the fence is broken down too here. The back of the house only about 10-15 feet in between the fence and somebody else's house. There's major foundation issues inside and outside visible. Big cracks. Otherwise the brick is fairly new looking, but there's a lot of cracks in the brick too. Outdoor air unit's been stripped. Metal chain link fence on the sides here, and then along the back might even be the neighbor's wood fence, and then we have that again, the chain link again in the front here. Shed looks in decent shape. More large foundation cracks. This sidewalk looks good. This little concrete pad looks good. The stairs definitely need work. Front stoop has concrete issues. Another crack in the foundation. The deck's in good shape. It's sturdy, level, wood's not too old. And the railings are sturdy. There's more evidence of the foundation shifts on the inside. Here's your living area. So you can see a big crack here, goes all the way up the ceiling over to there. Your living area could be opened up with the removal of this one wall here to the kitchen and dining area. It is all drywall. Need new cabinets and appliances. There's original wood under this laminate wood floor. But there's not enough visible to tell if we can save it, so. It's your side door. The front door is actually brand new. They've replaced it because to keep people from entering, I think. Here's your three bedrooms. This one's really small, 7'6" by 11. or 10 maybe. So I'm drawing small closet. Second bedroom's a little bigger. All the drywall is in pretty good shape. Needs some repairs. Besides all the areas where it's got some cracks from foundation. Small closet. Here's your shared bathroom. No vanity. All the tile, or a lot of the tiles come off. Needs major repairs or just to be retiled. This down here is messed up. And then last, the biggest bedroom, which has a half bath attached. Pretty good sized closet, but not quite for two people. Here's your half bath. The majority of the plumbing's been stripped, but as you can see, there's still some here at the bathtub hookup. Downstairs. First, this wasn't really visible on the outside. It's a huge crack and a huge bowing of the wall. It pops out quite a bit. Worse than I've really ever seen. So I think the structure here is a foundation is a major issue. Otherwise, it was finished originally. Plenty tall ceilings, 7'5" finished. This is a nice big living area. There's some pump down here, but I do not see French drains installed anywhere. There's a full bath with the stand-up shower. Utility room. The ductwork looks fine, but like I said, the outdoor unit got taken and the indoor unit, it looks pretty darn old. Hot water heater. Pretty rusty, and copper stripped off that. And last down here, looks like here was a washer dryer hookup. And a small bedroom here. And one more bedroom down here framed in. It's concrete floor throughout the basement. And last is the electric panel, 100 amp panel. The wiring looks fine, but I think we need more amps. The panel doesn't look that old.